Ladies and gentlemen, in this lecture we focus on DC to DC type of powertrain converters that facilitate the conversion from one DC voltage level to another DC voltage level. In particular, we will focus on the buck or step-down converter. The main learning objectives will fall under three questions. First, how to do the DC-DC converter works. Second, what are the operating states of a buck converter? And third, what is the ratio between the input voltage and output voltage of a DC to DC buck converter? The DC to DC converter is responsible for stepping up or down the input voltage Vin into the desired level of voltage at the output Vo. The input DC source can be, for instance, a DC link called high voltage DC bus, as you will see on the next slide. The output can be connected to a battery, for example. Based on the input to output voltage ratio, we recognize the buck or step down converter, where the output voltage is lower than the input voltage. The other converter is stepping up the voltage and is called the boost converter. In this lecture, we are going to have a look at one of the simplest forms of the DC voltage conversion, that is a buck converter or step down chopper. This figure shows a typical layout of a power electronic components in a battery electric vehicle. As you can see from the picture, that the battery is connected to the high voltage bus via a bidirectional DC to DC converter. Now let's zoom in this part. When the power transferred from the high voltage bus to the battery, which charges the battery through the regenerative braking, the voltage on the high voltage bus is stepped down to a lower voltage level for the battery. Therefore, this battery converter is working in the buck mode. At the lower right corner of the page, you can see the simplest diagram of the buck converter. At its left side is the higher voltage of the high voltage DC bus, and the lower battery voltage Vbat is at the right side. In this case, the higher voltage at the left side is the input voltage Vin, and the lower voltage at the right side is the output voltage Vout. In the figure, we show the circuit diagram of a simplified buck converter, which includes only a switch, a diode, and an inductor. The inductor is the main responsible for smoothing out the output current. In this figure, we can see the output voltage of the converter versus time. We define T on as the on time of the switch, whereas T is the total time of a period. If the switch is on, then the output voltage is equal to the input voltage. And if the switch is off, the output voltage is equal to zero. The output voltage is changing between two values, Vin and zero, and thus has a large ripple. As we can see in this figure, the average output voltage, V output average, in the dotted blue line, depend on the ratio of the on time of the switch and the total period. The diode is called freewheeling diode, which takes over the load current in the interval when the switch is off. Based on the simple diagram, in general case, if we add a capacitor, in parallel to the capacitor, we will help reduce the voltage ripple, which from the black waveforms to the one shown in blue, as seen in the figure. As we increase the value of the capacitor, the amount of the voltage ripple is further reduced. In the previous slides, we mentioned that the capacitor helps reduce the output voltage ripple, and indeed, the capacitor suppresses the rate of change of the output voltage, which is reflected as the current of the capacitor. This is mainly because the capacitor can maintain the voltage to some extent by absorbing or releasing its stored energy, EC, which depends on the capacitance and the square of the DC voltage across the capacitor. While the capacitor is used in parallel to the load, maintain the level of the DC voltage, an inductor can be employed in series to maintain the level of DC current. The inductor is smoothing out the rate of change of current that is reflected as the voltage across the inductor. Similarly, the inductor is able to release or absorb its stored energy, which depends on the inductance and the square of the current passing through the inductor. Let us now apply the buck converter on charging the battery through the regenerative braking. A battery is connected to the output and the voltage is the battery output voltage V0. We can consider two states of operation for the buck converter. In the first operating state, the input source is connected to the output, where it stores some energy in the inductor and charges the battery. Note that the voltage of the inductor, VL, is positive since the input voltage is larger than the output battery voltage. During the second state, the switch turns off and accordingly the input is disconnected from the inductor, and during this state the energy stored in the inductor is fed to the output, to the battery. Let's now see how the current of the inductor changes during these two operating states, as the inductor current is shown in the figure. During the first state, the current of the inductor increases, where the current derivative depends on the difference of the input and the output battery voltage. During the second operating state, the voltage across the inductor is equal to minus of the output voltage. During this state, the inductor releases the stored energy to the battery, which has some internal resistances too. The current derivative only depends on the output voltage. Let's see the voltage over the inductor during both on and off states of the switch. During one switching cycle in steady state, it is important to note that the average inductor voltage must be equal to zero. This means that the green area during the period on is equal to the red area during the off time, and as a result, the voltage of the inductor at the beginning and at the end of each cycle will remain the same. The graph shows the time intervals T on and T off, during which a switch turns on and turns off over a complete switching cycle respectively. The duty cycle is defined as the ratio of on time period divided by the complete switching cycle T. The value of the duty cycle ranges from 0 to 1. As we introduced before, the step down, or the so-called buck converters, are widely used to reduce the level of the input voltage. The output voltage of a buck converter is the product of the input voltage and duty cycle. In the application of the battery converter works in the buck mode, the output voltage to the battery, Vbat, is the product of the input voltage, V high voltage bus, and the duty cycle. Finally, there are different ways to chop or step down the DC voltage. First is the pulse width modulation method, or the PWM method, where the total time period of the signal T is fixed, and then the on time, T on, of the switch is changed. This method is effective when the fundamental switching frequency has to be constant. In the frequency modulation method, unlike the PWM method, the on time of the switch T on remains constant and the total period T changes. This method is used when the variable switching frequency is needed. To wrap up, in this video we focused on one of the most common DC to DC power converters, namely the buck or step-down converter. We evaluated two operating states of the converter during on time and off time of the switch. We introduced the concept of duty cycle and saw how the output of the buck converter is simply the product of input voltage and the duty cycle.